السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى أزواجه وذريته كما صليت على آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى أزواجه وذريته كما باركت على آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. We are back to سورة الطارق والسماء ذات الرجع. الرجع، he says the meaning of الرجع is المطر. الرجع meaning the rain. والأرض ذات الصدع. الصدع means الشق, the crack that is on earth. So Allah is making an oath by the rain that comes back again and again, the sky that brings back the rain and again and again, and the earth that has those cracks which it splits up and then you have a plant coming out. إِنَّهُ لَقَوْلٌ فَصْلٌ. He makes an oath subhanahu wa ta'ala that the Quran is a decisive word. قَوْلٌ يُمَيِّزُ بَيْنَ الْحَقِّ وَالْبَاطِلِ. It is a statement that distinguishes between truth and falsehood. وَمَا هُوَ بِالْهَزْلِ. The word al-hazl, it means the words that are not serious. Al-kalamu, the speech. غير al-jad, that is not serious. Or al-mizah, al-mizah, joking. Al-mizah, joking. Innahum yakiduna, they plot with evil. Yakidun, yakiduna bishar, or lishar, for evil. They plot in order to establish corruption and evil. مهل لا تستعجل عليهم. Do not hasten with them. Right? لا تعجل عليهم. With the disbelievers, مهل. أمهلهم. Give them time. Do not rush. رويدا meaning for a short while. قليلا. رويدا means قليلا. Now the next page, page 102. For those who are following the book, just the section on top with the words and their meanings there is a printing mistake there, right? They just repeated the previous words, the previous list of words from page 98. They just repeated it again, so that you just need to, you know, overlook it. And then we have the general meanings of the verses. He says على الرغم من أن القرآن حق, despite the fact, in spite of, على الرغم, in spite of the fact that القرآن is true, the Quran is true, والرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم صادق, and the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم is truthful, he tells the truth, إلا أن الكافرين مصرون على التكذيب. Yet, although the Quran is true, the messenger is truthful عليه الصلاة والسلام, yet إلا أن الكافرين مصرون على التكذيب. Yet the disbelievers, they insist, مصر, they are insisting upon belying, upon disbelieving in the Quran and disbelieving in the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. مصرون. ويدبرون الشر للإسلام والمسلمين, and they plot evil for or against Islam and Muslims. ولكن الله يطمئن المسلمين, but Allah يطمئن, comforts the Muslims, he gives them comfort and peace of mind. يطمئن. You know, in the salah you are supposed to have طمأنينة. In the salah you are supposed to be comfortable, you are supposed to be peaceful, not meaning rushing, right? In the salah you stand, you don't rush to bow down, you don't rush while you are bowing down, you stay there having tuma'nina, right? So here that word Al-Quran or the Prophet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yutam'in, gives comfort and peace of mind to the Muslims, أنه معهم يدبر لهم, that he سبحانه وتعالى, he is with them, he manages affairs for them, يدبر لهم, right? From the du'as that are mentioned, and not in in the hadith, but some of the pious people who made du'a, دبر لنا فإننا لا نحسن التدبير, manage for us our affairs, because we cannot manage them, we are not good managers, we do not cannot look after ourselves, you look after us, oh Allah, right? So one of the things that you ask Allah, you show humility to him, right? So here it says that he is subhanahu wa ta'ala with them, with the Muslims, يدبر لهم ويحفظهم ويبطل مخططات الأعداء, he is planning for them, in support of them, subhanahu wa ta'ala, he protects them, يحفظهم, and he invalidates the evil plots, the evil plans of the enemies, right? Those enemies are they're plotting and plotting. If it was other than the Muslim nation, it would have been wiped out long time ago, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِن كَانَ مَكْرُهُمْ لِتَزُولَ مِنْهُ الْجِبَالِ, that the evil plotting that they do, it can يعني it's so bad that it will make mountains move, right? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, من ورائهم محيط, he is all encompassing سبحانه وتعالى. That's why no matter how much they plot and plan against Islam and Muslims, yes, they might hurt, they might harm, but then Islam is still there and Muslims will remain there regardless of all of these evil plots. He says, إن الله تعالى أقوى من الكافرين, surely Allah is stronger than the disbelievers, وهو قادر على إهلاكهم وتعذيبهم, and he is all able to destroy them and to punish them, to torment them, ولكنه سبحانه يقول لرسوله الكريم, but he سبحانه وتعالى says to his noble messenger, لا تستعجل على هؤلاء, do not rush, do not hasten for these people, واصبر عليهم قليلا, be patient with them a little while, أنت والمسلمون, you and the Muslims, be patient with them a little, فإن نهاية الكفار معروفة, for the end of the disbelievers is well known, وهي خسارة في الدنيا, and it is loss in this worldly life, والعذاب الأليم في جهنم, and the painful torment in جهنم. Benefits and guidelines from the verses. Number one, كلام الله حق, the words of Allah are true, وصدق, and Allah tells the truth in what he says, لا هزل فيه ولا مزاح or مزاح, there is no joking in it, there is no fun, you know, just for fun, it's serious, it's words that are decisive. Also number two, الكافرون يخططون دائما لإيذاء المسلمين, the disbelievers, they always plot to harm the Muslims. Number three, الله تعالى يدافع عن المسلمين ويبطل خطط الأعداء, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defends the Muslims and he invalidates the plots, the plans, the evil plans. Khutta is a plan, right? He invalidates the plans of the enemies, al-a'da, adu, a'da, enemies. Number four, يطلب الله من المسلمين أن لا يتعجلوا العذاب للكافرين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala requests from the Muslims not to rush to ask for punishment for the disbelievers. Not to rush to ask punishment for the disbelievers. And number five, لله تعالى حكمة في تأخير العذاب عن الكافرين في الدنيا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has wisdom in him delaying the punishment from the disbelievers, delaying the punishment from the disbelievers in this worldly life. And this is how it was in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when the angel of the mountains came to him and he said, if you wish I will close up on them al-akhshabain, the two mountains of Mecca. He will have these two mountains get close up together and crush them. But Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam understood from Allah this issue of give them respite. So he said to the angel of the mountains, he said, no, rather I would give them time, right, until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may Allah guide them. And that's what happened for the majority of them. They accepted al-Islam. Alright, now tadribatun wa munaqashat, from our book, discussions, exercises and discussions. Number one, ajib bisah aw khata an al-jumal al-taliya. Answer with sah, that is correct, or wrong, khata, about the following sentences. This is page 103 for those who are following the book. A. Alif, عندما يعمل الكافر ذنبا يعذبه الله فورا. When the disbeliever does a sin or commits a sin, عندما يعمل, when the disbeliever does, عندما يعمل الكافر ذنبا, a sin, يعذبه الله فورا, Allah torments him and punishes him immediately. Is this true or false? It is false, right? And in the authentic hadith, that there is no one who is more patient for a harm that he hears more than Allah. لا أحد يعني أصبر على أذى سمعه من الله. They attribute to him the child, وَهُوَ يَرْزُقُهُمْ وَيُعَافِهِمْ, while he is providing sustenance for them and he gives them well-being. Yet they are ascribing children to him, that he has children. If he wished, he will punish them immediately, but he doesn't, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is patient with them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. B. الْمَاءُ يَتَبَخَّرُ من البحار إلى السماء, من البحار إلى السماء, وهي ترجعه إلى الأرض. The water evaporates from the seas up to the sky, and it, that is the sky, brings it back to earth. True or false? Right? صح. Right? صح. The first one was خطأ. This one is صح. This is one of the meanings of والسماء, that الرجع. الرجع, we said that it rains and it rains again and again and again. But one of the meanings is that this water, rainwater that comes down, is actually just coming back to the earth, because it evaporates from the seas and then it comes back to the earth. So it is coming back, really. Right? That's one of the meanings they mention for والسماء ذات الرجع, by the sky that brings back, right, brings back the rain. Jim or C, القرآن يفرق بين الحق والباطل. The Quran differentiates, distinguishes between truth and falsehood. This is صح, right, صح or خطأ. صح, صح meaning it is correct. Right? Al-Quran is itself called a criterion. Al-Furqan. Right? Al-Furqan. It differentiates between truth and falsehood. Number three, he says to us, أكمل, complete, الجمل التالية, the following sentences, بكلمات من السورة, with words from the chapter, this surah that we learned. So now, once again, the intention behind authoring the book, the author, he says, Dr. Zaid Al-Ais, حفظه الله تعالى, He wants to teach us the Quran, the meanings of the Quran in Arabic, in easy Arabic. So now we learned some words, so we're supposed to use them in sentences. He says, المسلم يبتعد عن في كلامه. The Muslim, he stays away from dots in his speech, right? So the Muslims, he stays away from words that we got from the surah, right? إنه لقول فصل وما هو بالهزل. What is الهزل? Right, playing around and joking and musings and amusement. So when you speak seriously. It is okay to joke sometimes, but joke with the truth as it is in the sunnah, and not too much, a little, not too much, right? But in general, the Muslim is serious. So he tells you something, then you take it to be serious, not like, okay, I was joking, and the other one he was joking, and the third one he was joking, then this person is not serious. You don't take what he says seriously, right? The next line, Al-Kuffaru, and he has dots, disbelievers, dots, للمسلمين, towards the Muslims. إنهم يكيدون. يكيدون. They plot, right? إنهم يكيدون. So here we use this word, الكفار, the disbelievers, يكيدون. They plot للمسلمين, against the Muslims. Number جيم or C. تظهر الغيوم في dots dots. The clouds show up in, if you are in English, you will say the sky, which is السماء تظهر الغيوم. The clouds, they show up, they emerge in the sky, in the sky. في السماء, في السماء. So this was the end of this chapter, Surah At-Tariq. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to revive our hearts through the Quran, and يحيي قلوبنا بالقرآن, to make us from those who listen to our statement and follow the best of it, and to bless us with the noble Quran, and to make us from those who truly follow it in terms of reciting it, in terms of memorizing it, and in terms of actualizing it in our life, and having it being applied in our daily lives. Jazakumullahu khairan for listening and paying attention, and we can have a few minutes for questions and answers, and I understand there is also a speaker that will give a short reminder, inshallah. I have a question from the sisters that came before Salah. That's the first one that came, and the sister is asking about if there is a book that teaches the I'rab of Juz Am, right? That teaches the I'rab, telling you the words of the sentences of Juz Am through the Arabic grammar, you know, giving you the place of each word in the sentence and what is it. There are so many books in this regard, and some of them are authored in an easy يعني, way. Inshallah, I will send a link to our brother Awala, inshallah, and you can get that link from him. Inshallah, you can download it and look at it. There are a number of books. There is one for the whole Quran. Of course, there are detailed books that do the I'rab. There are so many of them. But there is one that is printed in just one volume. So you have the lines, yani the Quran, and under it, it tells you this is a verb, this is يعني the noun, this is an adjective. It shows just under each word, it says what it is, right? Of course, there are many ways the Quran can have I'rab, but then they try to cut down and do it short. It comes in one big volume, but it has the whole Quran. I think the sister, she wants to, she's asking, that's how I understand it, she wants to see an I'rab book of the last part of the Quran that is something that is done like this book. And there is a book, and yani, inshallah I will send that link to the brother Awal, inshallah, and you can get it from him, inshallah. Yes. Ayyakum.
Min. I've
certain
meaning in English.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And of.
Of, yes.
When can you differentiate?
When can you
know how
to? It depends on the place of the sentence. The place of it in the sentence. In our surah here, mostly of is suitable for all. You can use from too, but of is more suitable to use it in all places. Yes. So if there are no questions, inshallah, I would ask you to remain, inshallah, here, not to leave.